Hi guys, this is Ugur. Today we will talk about how to implement an email-based authentication with an email confirmation. So in this video we will only talk about the system design, and in the next video we will actually implement it using Next.js 14 server components and server actions and Lucia out package and third-party email service that I didn't decide yet. Okay. First of all, we will need a sign up page. I'm assuming that we have a form for username and password. And generally, we put another input for confirmation password so that we ensure that user has entered the correct password they wanted to enter. And finally, we have a submit button, right? It's a basic form. When the submit button has clicked, we don't send any request to server yet because we need to validate the form in the client first. So we will check if email is a valid email and passwords are just valid password. For example, if they are matching with each other, password and confirm password. Or maybe we set a length limit or capitalization, etc. We check those in the client as well before we sending any request to server. So let's say if it's passed, then we will send a request to our server. Our server will execute a function. Let's call it signup function. It also gets the values email, password, and confirm password. In this function, we do all validations again. We do validations in client and we do validation in server as well. If the validation is not successful, we return an error to the page like this, and we can show some kind of error toast maybe in the page. If this has been successful, we continue to execute, right? So what we can do is we need to first create a user with these values, email and password. Let's actually have another function for creating user, create user, and it will get email and password. And we will actually need to hash the password first. We don't ever store the plain password in our database. It's a big no and we shouldn't do it. So we are hashing the password some kind of algorithm like SHA-256, or we can just use bcrypt library to encrypt password. But yeah, the idea is hashing the password. After that, we can create a record in the DB. And if it's successful, so that means that we created a record in our database, and user table will look like this. Let's call it user table and ID. That may be a UUID or incremental integer. So yeah, you pick, but I prefer UUID. This is our primary key, and we will have email, and it should be unique, and hash password. And finally, since we will implement an email verification later, we will add a field for this. Is email verified? And default must be false. Perfect. And let's create other table that we will need before going further. So the second table we need is actually email verification table, which will have an ID and user ID, which will be foreign key. And it just references to a user ID here like this, and the code, I mean the verification code we will generate, and it will be string. Perfect. So we only need two tables for a start. Okay, we created a record in the database. So we have email, hash password, and we set is email verified to false, and we will continue to our process here. In the success case, we will call, okay, let's say create user, and after that we will generate the email verification code, generates email code, and of course this create user could throw an error, right? So we should also consider this. If it gives an error, we should again return an error to the page here and show some kind of toast or error. And why will this give an error if there is already an email that registered in our database, we can throw an error, like email is already in use. After we successfully saved user in our database, we will need another function that generates a code for us, encrypt this code with the user ID. Then we will call another function for sending email, if that makes sense. So the idea is generate. So we will call another function, generates code. Actually, let's call it generate token. It's because we will generate a GWT token, and you will see the reason in a bit. This function will take a parameter user ID, which is string, and generate a random string. You can define some rules here, like maybe you want to generate a random numerical values or capitalized values. You are free to pick. I will create 6-character long string. We have user ID and a code, right? And we will generate a JWT token that has user ID and code as a claim. So we will return something like start with AY, blah, blah, blah. It's a JWT token. So we are generating this token because once user collect the link in its email, we will directly authenticate user and redirect them to our dashboard. So that's why we need their user ID, and we need the code because we want to compare the codes in our database and the code that we generate here. And since we are using JWT, we are sure that the payload cannot be changed, because once it changed, it is disrupted, and it is how JWT works actually. Everyone can read it, but no one can change it except they know the secret key. Of course, we will have a secret key while generating this token that we keep secret. That's why we call it secret. Yeah, anyway, generating this token, we will return the token here, return success, right? After it's successful, we will finally call send verification email. So it's another function, like send verification. It will have two parameters. One is token, the token we generated, and other is email. This is the recipient, right? It will be another string. And yeah, we can always validate token and email if they are not exist, or if it's not a valid email, we can throw an error. And we can do the same thing in this generate token function. So we can wrap this with a try catch, and if something goes wrong, we can just throw an error. In send verification email, after getting and validating the parameters, we call our email service. Here, let's say we have an send email function that comes from this service, right? So we will give the token an email, and we send the mail to this email. So the contents could be something like, welcome to blah blah, for continuing, please verify your account by clicking this link. So we append a link here. Actually, this should be a content actually, and we should generate the content here. Welcome to blah blah, and here is the link. And the link should be something like this. It's your host, example.com, and you should have a path. Let's call it verify email, and it will take a query called token in our cases, and here we will append our JWT token here. So content should look like this, and after we call this here, and we can of course return a success or error here. I mean, after this, actually this will return a success as well. And finally, we will show a toast, like we send an email to your inbox, please check your inbox. For the user experience perspective, we should also have some kind of, okay, we send an email to you, but you may not receive this. So do you want to try it again? That's why after we show some successful message or toast here, we should have a button sent again. And once it's clicked, we should actually call our server again. Yes, like this, it's getting complicated. Maybe I draw not good, but our server will call another function in this case, which will be actually sign up function without creating the user. So we can, those are the common things. And our server will call another function, resend verification email, right? And let's put arrow here. And what does this function do? It will get a user ID as parameter. And we will check if this user ID exists in our user table and is email verified, set it to false. If it's true, we don't send it again. And we show your email is already verified. And we will do same thing actually here. We will generate a token. And actually, I passed a step in the signup function because we didn't ever store our code in the email verification, right? So before we send a verification email to user, we save token in email verification table. After we generating the code, we save it in our email verification table. So back to resend verification email here. Yeah, we check if the user exists and is email verified set to false, and we generate token. And what do we do next is update email verification table, because we have old code here that we sent earlier and we need to update it with the new code. And we will send verification email with our user ID and the code here. Now, one thing you may ask that, okay, we generating code and we update the code, and but generally the token gets expired after some time, right? We do it in actually generate code function. Since we are generating a JWT token, we can define a time that this token expires, and we will check this time in the next step actually. So we are done with this, and we are resending verification email, and we should return a success to our server, and our server should return a success to client and show a toast. We resend a verification email, and at this step we should disable this send again button. You should have seen this before in various of applications. So they disable and they have a label, small label that says you can try it again after 300 seconds later. So they have a kind of timeout, right? After that time passes, user can try it again. But there is something that we need to be careful about. We are disabling this button in the client side, but someone that has bad intentions can hit our endpoint. Actually here, once we click here, we send a request to our server, which has just a URL and gets a payload. So if someone takes that URL and puts some payload and hit that endpoint over and over again, since they don't use client here, they would be able to send dozens of email to them. So that's why we should also have a logic in our server that actually checks what was the last time that we sent the email. For that reason, we can actually add a new field to email verification table, sent at, let's call it sent at, and its type is date. We are sending the email here and return a success here, right? And update table with sent at. So we update our email verification table to put a sent at value. And in this resend verification email, after checking if user exists, we also check if sent at bigger than 5 minutes. And if it's not bigger than 5 minutes, we just return an early error in our server. So we blocked our client and we also blocked our server. So we secure our system here. If it's been 5 minutes or bigger than 5 minutes, we can just continue generating the token and update verification table with new code. And after sending verification email, update email table, email verification table with sent at value. Okay, for sign up, let's continue with email verification. Yeah, what happens? A user click the link in their inbox. So they redirected to a URL such as this here. Once they click, they will redirect to our page, our client. So we grab the token from query params. We send it to our server. And in our server, we will resend a request to our server, and our server will return an error or a success. If it's a success, it should set a cookie that is marked HTTP only that has JWT token as a value. So then we can redirect user to our dashboard, and we can call get user information API to get the user's information, since we have JW token inside our cookies that is marked with HTTP only flag. Our server can be sure that user has logged in, and it can return the user's information. Then the client can use the information to show relevant data to user. And in the case of it returns an error, so let's say the token may be expired. In this case, server returns an error and we show a toast. The token is expired. Please send it again. So we can have we can have a button, send verification email again, etc. I actually don't want to draw anymore. It's getting messier. But yeah, the idea is grabbing token here, send it to server. Server decode this JWT and be sure that it is valid. And once it's valid, it sets, it updates the user table here. It puts is email verified field to true, and we actually then we remove this row in our email verification table that corresponds to our user. Then after doing these two operations, so updating is email verified and removing the row here, and we return a success here. After a success message, user will be able to see the dashboard or protected route that you may want to redirect them. Another case will be, so user sign up here and then close this page. And another day, it just comes to a sign-in page, tries to log in, right? So in this case, we will compare email and password in our server. So if they are not correct, we just return incorrect email or password. After we ensuring that email and password is correct, we checked email verified true. So if it's true, we just log them in. I mean, the server does. In the sign-in page, we just send a request to server, and those happens in the server. If it's true, server returns a JWT token or any other information that is needed. But if is email verified is not true, server will return an error, and we show an error in the sign-in page, which we can say you must verify your email before signing in. Maybe put a button here again saying send verification email, or you can say you need to verify your email and we send a new email to verify your account. And again, then you will have something, didn't you get the email? Send it again. So same again, user may not get the email. So that's why we will have this resend button in every page. Yeah, I think that's all, and I didn't forget anything, hopefully. And in the next video, we will code this in Next.js 14, and you will see that it's actually so easy to do it and nothing to be scared of. Okay, this was Ugur, and thank you for watching. And if you want to support me, you can subscribe to the channel. I'm just starting, and I appreciate you if you watch this long. And I hope it was actually helpful to you. Okay, take care and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.